वेलकम टू 10th स्टैंडर्ड जियोग्राफी यूनिट 2 इंडिया फिजियोग्राफी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीन द वीडियो ऑफ सोशल साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक क्वेश्चन विद द आंसर्स। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी दम अगेन, क्लिक ऑन द आई बटन हियर। दिस वीडियो कंसिस्ट ऑफ इंपॉर्टेंट एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन अदर दैन टेक्स्ट बुक क्वेश्चन। लेट्स बिगिन। Answer the following questions. First question: Name the three parallel ranges of the Himalayas. The three parallel ranges of the Himalayas are: first one, Greater Himalayas; second one, Lesser Himalayas; third one, Shivalik Hills. These are the three parallel ranges of the Himalayas. Let's move to question number 2. Write briefly about the Greater Himalayas. Answer is: they are the innermost continuous and highest ranges. The average height of the range is 6,100 meters. These ranges have many high peaks, of which Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. As the Greater Himalayas are covered with the snow throughout the year, these ranges are called Himadri. They are the home of many glaciers such as Gangotri and Yamunotri glaciers. There are many passes such as Burzil, Jojila, Shipkila, etc. These are all about the Greater Himalayas. Let's move to question number 3. Write briefly about the Lesser Himalayas. Answer is: these ranges are located to the south of the Greater Himalayas. They are also known as Himachal. They are 60 to 80 kilometers wide and 1500 to 4500 meters high. The eastern part is covered with forests. There are many parallel ranges in the Lesser Himalayas, example, the Pir Panjal, the Dauladhar. They contain many valleys such as Kashmir Valley, Kangra Valley, Kulu Valley, etc. They are also noted for hill stations such as Shimla, Raniket, etc. These are all about the Lesser Himalayas. Let's move to question number 4. State the importance of the Northern Great Plain. Answer is: it is very suitable for irrigation and agriculture as it has perennial rivers and vast fertile alluvial soil. Its level land supports a network of roads, railways and means of communication. They are useful for industrialization, urbanization and trade. A number of pilgrim centers are located here. These are all about the importance of the Northern Great Plain. Let's move to question number 5. Explain the importance of the Peninsular Plateau. Answer is, Peninsular Plateau is rich in minerals, thick forests and biodiversity. It has influence on southwest monsoons and it is covered with black soil, which is useful for agriculture. The Western Ghats are the birthplace of many South Indian rivers. They are useful for the generation of hydroelectricity. It is also well known for hill stations such as Ooty. These are all about the importance of the Peninsular Plateau. Let's move to question number 6. Write briefly about the Western Coastal Plain. Answer is, it lies between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea. It extends from the run of Kutch to Kanyakumari. It is narrow, steep and rocky. It can be divided into three parts: the Konkan Coast, the Karnataka Coast, the Malabar Coast. These are all about the Western Coastal Plain. Let's move to question number 7. Write briefly about the Eastern Coastal Plain. Answer is, this extends from the north of river Subarnarekha to Kanyakumari. It lies between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal. It is broader than the Western Coastal Plain. Many rivers of South India flow across the plain and they have formed deltas, that is, the Mahanadi and the Godavari. It is divided into two parts, the Northern Sarkar and the Coromandel Coast. Some lagoons are formed in this coastal plain, such as Lake Chilka, Lake Puliket. These are all about the Eastern Coastal Plain. Let's move to question number 8. Explain the importance of the coastal plains of India. The importance of coastal plains of India are, they provide some natural harbors which help in carrying on foreign trade. They are Kandla, Mumbai, Marmagua, Kochi, Visakhapatnam, Kolkata, etc. The coastal plain are useful for fishing, shipbuilding, agriculture and production of salt. Many beaches are found along the coast and they attract tourists. The backwaters are useful for navigation. These are all about the importance of coastal plains of India. Let's move to question number 9. Distinguish between the western coastal plains and the eastern coastal plains. Answer is, the western coastal plains, it lies between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea. The eastern coastal plains, it lies between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal. Next point. It extends from the run of Kutch to Kanyakumari. It extends from the north of river Subarnarekha to Kanyakumari. Next point, it is narrow, steep and rocky. It is broader than the western coastal plain. Last point, it can be divided into three parts, the Konkan coast, the Karnataka coast, the Malabar coast. It is divided into two parts, the Northern Sarkar and Coromandel coast. These are all the differences between the western coastal plains and the eastern coastal plains. Let's move to question number 10. Explain the islands of India. Answer is, there are about 247 islands in India. Of these, 204 are in the Bay of Bengal and 43 are in the Arabian Sea. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands are in the Bay of Bengal. The Lakshadweep Islands are in the Arabian Sea and are formed by corals. These are all about the islands of India.